Welcome to Slavonski Brod, Croatia, 2019, 2nd of June, and we have a very wet, cloudy, humid weather. The whole weather situation was interesting, at least for the past week, if not more, because there was a low pressure system that kind of got stuck over the East Balkan, caused a lot of thunderstorms and heavy hail over Romania, and storms extended all the way from Romania to Greece and from Black Sea to East Croatia, where we are now. So the ground is really soggy. Everywhere where the cars have driven over the grass is now a mud field, and wherever we are walking there's just water pouring out of ground. Anyway, we were lucky with this weekend. We only had a couple of showers. Majority of the storms were just few kilometers east of us, so we could make 5 rounds yesterday and 2 more today, and only got maybe 1.5 hours of interruption because of rain in these both days. This is now the first flyoff with 8 best pilots. Since this is the first time competition is held here, and because of the weather forecast, there are only 35 pilots here attending, which is not as much as we've grown to expect with other competitions, which have 80 or more competitors. But I find this a very nice field, great hospitality, all the infrastructure in place, great food. So with better weather, I'm sure next year there will be many, many more pilots here. Two planes on the ground already. Three are still low, fighting for something. Actually fighting for time, looking for some thermals somewhere. And it was amazing to watch these past 2 days. We've never seen sun directly, and there was maybe just a few minutes when we could see sun through the clouds. It was always cloudy, even low clouds bordering on fog, but yet stars from 20, 30, 40 meters were completely visible and doable. And we've seen some really impressive starts from low height in a kind of weather that in normal days I wouldn't even step out of my apartment. But since this is a competition weekend, you have to fly with the weather that is there and make the most out of it, so it's a good training. We've had slight wind from the north, mostly changing from east to west, so I should say variable, only few meters per second, nothing drastic. Yet it was enough to stimulate some people to fly really far away. I think there's now the third pilot landed. And I think this is Arjan now gaining height, finally. Looks like one more plane has gone down. Now only four remain. And now sun has come out. That's first time this weekend. Looks like these two guys will now make it.
5 minutes until the end of working time.
So who's now still flying? One minute and 20 seconds till the end of the first flyoff. Four pilots that made it are getting ready to land.
1 minute until the end of working time.
Okay, 4 out of 8. Let's do the next flight. The sports airfield in Slavonski Brod is conveniently located just on the edge of town. And just there behind the hangar, it's actually a major shopping center. So if you forgot anything at home, or you want to check local food prices, it's walking distance away, really. Very convenient. Another less convenient fact is that behind those houses there's River Sava, which is border between Croatia and Bosnia, and also border between European Union and outside of European Union, which is now a different world. That ugly concrete building that you see, that's already on the Bosnian side. Of course, not that long ago, this was all one country. Now the situation is completely changed. You can see from the clouds just how much moisture there is in the air and how low the cloud base is. The whole place is really, really humid. And I guess this gave us all the nice air to fly in over the weekend. My experience, when there's fog, there's always lift. Okay, now this crowd here is more or less in the same place as the previous start. And I hope I'm at a bit better place to observe it. This start height is not super low, maybe 30-35 meters or so, but as you can see, it's more than enough. Especially now that the sun is out. And with all this moisture, I guess a good hand toss should be enough. This time all the pilots will make it, no real difficulties. Even the lowest one has now gained quite a lot of height. So one thing that was maybe unusual about this weekend is that we all had interesting technical problems with all the moisture and humidity. I don't know if it was the weather or the vicinity of houses and residential area, but quite few of us had interesting radio problems. Planes being thrown in safe mode, dropping butterfly in the middle of a turn, typically close to houses. It was a bit stressful. But as I understand, only one plane actually got lost and was later found in the middle of the Sava River, hanging on a tree on an island there. Another interesting issue was that all these sticky tapes we have as seals for the gaps in the ailerons and rudders, etc. The rain washed all of the powdery stuff away from the parts where they should not stick, and so they started to stick and limited the movements of ailerons and rudder in my case. So that was a bit annoying. And the funny thing is that it's hard to find any thin powdery substance on the field because no one is really willing to carry it with them and risk a border check and then spending hours convincing them what that white powdery substance is. Could be an unpleasant experience. As you can see, all the planes are now safely high and the pilots will just wait for the remaining time to pass. Less than 2 minutes to go and the sky is full of whistling noises of the planes losing height fast. Contest director said the free landing because there was basically no wind.
1 minute
so the pilots are free to approach the landing point however they wish. And from what I've seen, at least 2 collisions on landing were at least partly caused by this. So I'm not a great fan of this decision.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, and that was the second flight. Now only the third one remains.
Time.
There's now a gust of wind there over the hangar and not here. Let's see how the pilots will interpret this. Everyone very low. And I mean really low. I think that guy now, that is the lowest, it's also the farthest away, should come a bit closer to us. Or maybe he can wait there for the wind to bring good air to him. It's a bit tight now there over those bushes. That's even behind the bushes, I believe. But for sure there is some good air there. There's one plane coming towards us, and the one following him. I'm not sure if they will make it. One's in the grass and the other will be soon. two down. It was just single wrong choice. Gooder was not in front, but apparently a bit behind and to the west. All the planes are now in that direction and climbing happily. Looks it's quite large area as well. All are circling and climbing. I even see a bird now there in between that came out to check what's going on in there. There's now a bit of a wind. And about 4 minutes remaining. About 50 seconds remaining. Nicely done. No crashes, no drama. Let's wait for the results.
Once again, I want to thank you all for coming. I know that we have some weather issues these days, but it wasn't my will. And now, I will say something about our youngest pilots. They also were great, great performance. And second place as junior from Greece. Christos Tanavaras. Bravo. First place, Junior, from Slovenia, Martin Liberšek.
Bravo!
And now, stay here, stay here. And now,
Martin,
our finalist was on the 8th place from Croatia, Leon Matic. Oh. 7th place from Austria, Gernot Peng. Oh. 6th place from Bulgaria, Angel Karadinev. Fifth place from Croatia, Nikola Francic. Fourth place from Germany, Sebastian Mannhardt. Finally, third place after long, long time from Croatia, Sasha Pečinar. Second place from Slovenia, with lot of experience, Primož Rižner. Bravo!
Lots of experience.
And the winner of our contest, first Kuka Broda, F5J, Arjan Kucalju from Croatia. And there's also a special prize for our winner from Nan Models, a brand new model.